You know, when it comes to computing, storage media is a fairly large topic with a lot of history. Now, I'm not trying to age myself, but during my career, I've watched as the industry has moved from tape, diskettes, floppy disks, zip disks, jazz disks, CDs, external hard disks, DVDs, Blu-ray, and more recently, the flash drive. And sure, some of the storage mediums that I just mentioned are still in use today, and some of them actually, well, never caught on. I mean, do you even remember jazz disks? Have you heard of that before? Yeah, that's what I thought. But even though many storage mediums have come and gone, the flash drive appears to be here to stay. Well, at least for now. And flash drives are great for us Linux users because in addition to being a great way to store files, they come in quite handy whenever it's time to install a new Linux distribution. We simply download an ISO image and then write it to a flash drive. And then, from that point forward, the flash drive becomes an installer for that distribution. But if you're like me and you constantly try out new Linux distributions, you probably have a basket of flash drives at this point. I mean, look at all of these. These are actually the flash drives that I've been using. And it even got to the point on my end where I bought a label maker just so I could keep track of which flash drive is which. And if you think about it, we've kind of come full circle, haven't we? I mean, remember flipping through a CD wallet to find a specific distro disk? Well, I have news for you. How we do it nowadays isn't all that better. But recently, my friend Tom actually recommended a solution to this problem.
Hey, are you using Ventoy? It's the best thing you should be using for all of your multi-boot needs.
Now, as someone who watches the Linux industry fairly closely, I already knew about Ventoy. It's been on my radar for quite a while. But considering that Tom, as well as some of you guys, have recommended that I try out Ventoy, I figured it was finally time to give it a shot. But what exactly is Ventoy? I mean, from the name, it kind of sounds like a toy Venn diagram or something. Well, actually, what Ventoy is it's a tool that can convert a flash drive into a Swiss Army knife of bootable ISO images. It's simple to use, and once you've finished setting it up, you could boot a computer from one flash drive, and from that one flash drive, you could choose from any of the distro images that you've saved on that device. And for the most part, you're only limited to how much space you have available on that flash drive. In fact, here's my Ventoy right here. What I did was I decided to go a little crazy and download every single distribution on DistroWatch, so this flash drive right here contains an image for every distribution on DistroWatch. That's crazy. Now, obviously, that's overkill. You don't have to do that. But Ventoy is awesome, and it's something that I started using recently, so I figured I would make a video for you guys to show you how to use it. So if you follow along with me, you'll have your very own Ventoy set up by the end of the video. But before we get to that, I need to take a moment and mention the sponsor for today's video, Linode. Linode is a cloud server provider with a focus on Linux. And if you use the URL that you see on the screen right now, you'll have access to $100 in starter credit towards your new account. And with their platform, you can spin up your very own Linux server in the cloud. And that means you won't be limited to being a distro hopper on your computer. You could be a distro hopper in the cloud as well and test a bunch of distributions there too. They have all the stables available, such as Debian, CentOS, Fedora, Arch Linux, and there's a bunch more where that came from. In fact, Kali Linux is available on their platform now as well. And yes, you heard that right. You can actually have Kali Linux running on a cloud instance. And I have to say, whoever pitched that idea internally within Linode deserves a round of applause. And Linode not only has a bunch of distributions available, they also have quite a few data centers as well. In fact, with Linode being recently acquired by Akamai, they're actually planning on rolling out an additional dozen data centers, and that's going to be awesome. In fact, what I would like you to do is check out the URL that you see on the screen right now. And with that URL, you can be set up with $100 in free starter credit towards your new account. And there's a whole lot of distributions that you could try within that credit. The platform is a lot of fun, and I highly recommend it. So thank you yet again to Linode for sponsoring this video, as they've done for many of the videos on this channel. I really appreciate it. Now with all of that out of the way, it's time to get started. As usual, what I'll do is include time codes in the description down below. That way, you could get right to the section that most interests you. Let's go ahead and get started. So what exactly is Ventoy? Now, I've already mentioned a few details about it, so you probably have a general idea of what it does already. But I think it's a good idea to make sure that it's a fit for your use case before you go through the trouble of setting it up. So let's make sure that we fully understand what exactly it can do for us. As I mentioned earlier, if you have a handful of bootable flash drives that you maintain for various Linux distributions and tools you may use, then you already know what a pain it could be to keep track of them all. The idea around Ventoy is that it enables you to consolidate the majority of those flash drives down to just one. Anytime you want to add a new bootable image to your Ventoy flash drive, you simply plug it in and copy the image file over to it. And that's it. It's very easy to use, it's incredibly useful, and best of all, it's completely free. So at this point, if you are still watching this video, then that must mean that I've sold you into Ventoy and you're considering using it. If that's the case, then how exactly do you get started with it and what do you need? Well, that's the easy part. All you need is a flash drive. That's it. Literally, that's all you need in order to get started with Ventoy. Just a flash drive, and then you download the tool, and that's all you need. Now, of course, it's not as simple as just a flash drive. I mean, if you were to use a very cheap and slow flash drive, you're probably not going to have a good experience. For the best result, you probably want a large flash drive, something that's large enough to hold a bunch of ISO images, but you also want a USB 3 flash drive with reasonable speeds. So in summary, if you have a fast flash drive with a lot of storage available, then that's the perfect flash drive for this project. Now, if you don't already have a preference, then what I'll do is actually give you an affiliate link down below to the flash drive that I decided to use for my Ventoy. And it's actually worked out quite well for me, and I highly recommend it. And like I mentioned before, Ventoy is free, so it won't cost you anything to download Ventoy. The only cost for entry here is the cost of your flash drive. And there's downloads available for various operating systems on their download page, so you can actually download it for Windows as well as macOS. Most of the time when you download an application from the internet, it installs on your computer, but that's not what Ventoy does. Instead, it's best to think of Ventoy as a converter tool. When you launch the tool, you simply tell it which flash drive you want it to use and convert into a Ventoy flash drive, and then at that point, Ventoy is installed on the flash drive, not your computer. And that's all there is to it when it comes to setting it up. After that, when it comes to adding additional ISO images to your Ventoy, all you have to do is insert it back into your computer. From there, you simply browse your files and find the flash drive in your file manager. And then at that point, you simply copy ISO images to the flash drive. That's all there is to it. So if you've ever saved a file onto a flash drive, then you already know the process of adding an ISO image to Ventoy. To use it, you simply insert your Ventoy USB key into your computer. And then at that point, you start up your computer, pressing whatever the hotkey is for your computer to activate the boot menu. And then from there, you're presented with a list of ISO images that you have copied to the device. As you can see, I have quite a few on mine. Like I mentioned, I have the entirety of DistroWatch on one flash drive. Anyway, you simply highlight the entry that you want to boot from and press enter. And that's it. That's all there is to it. So, as you can see, Ventoy enables you to have multiple ISO images on one flash drive, rather than always having to dedicate a single flash drive to one particular ISO file. And this tool is something that I feel is going to be quite useful for several different types of people. For example, if you're a fan of Linux like I am, and you want to test various Linux distributions from time to time, then in that case, Ventoy will be indispensable. You can literally store as many ISO files as your flash drive has available space for. But it's not just for us Linux enthusiasts, there's other use cases as well. For example, it's great for system administrators as well. And that's because ISO files exist for more than just Linux distributions. There's some awesome diagnostic utilities out there as well. Sysadmins may use tools like gparted for editing partitions, memtest86 for troubleshooting memory, maybe the System Rescue CD for general troubleshooting, Clonezilla for imaging hard disks, and you could even store ISO files for Windows releases if you also maintain Windows installations as well. And when it comes to those of you with a home lab, there's probably all kinds of ISO images that you may want to use from time to time, maybe Proxmox or TrueNAS or any of the other tools that home labbers often set up on their network. Or maybe you're an extreme enthusiast and you have a use case for everything that I've mentioned. In that case, you should absolutely try out Ventoy. So at this point, Ventoy probably sounds really awesome, and it is. But there are a few downsides that I would like to bring to your attention. Nothing crazy or insurmountable, but there's a few things that I would like you to understand. And one of the things that you might run into is that some ISO images just don't play well with Ventoy for whatever reason. Now, this isn't something that's wrong with Ventoy itself. It's just that sometimes there's some non-standard ISO images out there, and it is what it is. However, every now and then, Ventoy releases new updates, and some of those updates actually address compatibility issues with specific ISO images. So if you do have an ISO image that doesn't work with Ventoy for whatever reason, maybe you should still keep it on the drive, and then later on, you never know. Once you update Ventoy, it might start working. But how exactly do you update Ventoy? Well, just like everything else with Ventoy, the process is simple. All you have to do is download the latest version whenever it comes out, and then you run it against your flash drive again. If you already have Ventoy set up on that flash drive, and the tool you're using is newer than the one that you've downloaded before, then Ventoy will give you an option to update it. And that's all there is to it. So for that reason, I recommend that you check the Ventoy download page every now and then and just see if a new version is available. Now, you don't have to constantly update it or anything like that, but if you simply check for an update once or twice a year, well, I think that's good enough. Now, there's another potential downside with Ventoy that I would like you to be aware of. And just like the first one, this isn't actually a problem with Ventoy itself, but it is an industry thing that I would like you to keep in mind. Some distributions actually don't release installers at all. The images that you download from some of these distribution sites are images that are intended to be written to an SD card. And Raspberry Pi OS is a really good example of that. In this case, that's not something that Ventoy is going to help you with because that's outside the scope of what the project actually solves. And because of the fact that not every single distribution image is bootable, then that means some of the images that I've saved on my Ventoy are actually not going to work. So while yes, I do technically have an image for each of the distributions on DistroWatch on one flash drive, not all of them are actually going to work. Again, that's an industry thing and not something specific to Ventoy. But if you do have a bootable ISO image, then Ventoy is a great solution and something that I highly recommend you check out. Especially if you have a bunch of images like I do, then Ventoy can consolidate a bunch of flash drives down to as few as just one flash drive. But when it all comes down to it, Ventoy has been incredibly useful for me, and I really do love this software. It's just so cool. I mean, you saw earlier just how many flash drives I have, and how many I actually maintain, so it's probably a good thing to consolidate everything down to one and have just one thing to maintain. But not only that, what Ventoy is also useful for on my end is capturing B-roll for various Linux distributions. I can simply store a bunch of distros on one USB flash drive, and then anytime I need to capture footage from a specific distro, well, it's really easy to do. I kind of wish I just started using this earlier. If only I've listened to you guys when you first mentioned this to me, I would have probably have saved myself a lot of work. Anyway, Ventoy is awesome. It's something that I use virtually every week now, and it's saved me quite a bit of work. I have a bunch of Linux distributions on mine, as you've seen, so it's definitely coming in handy. Now, what's your opinion of Ventoy and this video in general? Let me know in the comments down below this video. I'm very curious to hear what your opinions are. But in the meantime, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.